Frank here with Shadow Tessier, and it's a rather blowy day and rather overcast, completely unlike the wonderful harvest we've been having. We're going to be having a chat with Neil and Olivier afterwards to discuss what we think of the vintage 2010. But in the meantime, today is a traditional day. We have what is called a gobabod, which means the vintage lunch. And so Olivier is going to lead you in and show you the crew we're about to have make merry. Okay, so I'm talking with Jean-Pierre, who's just joined us about 2 weeks ago, I think, now.
Yeah.
And Jean-Pierre is from a négociant background, in other words, the Place de Bordeaux. And my question really is, Jean-Pierre, do you find a great difference between working here and what's the difference, essentially, between a négociant and a producer?
Well, I don't know for all the producers, but as far as Chateau Tessier is concerned, I don't see much difference with what the négociant is doing, because Chateau Tessier is very active in terms of commercialization. So there is not much difference, except that the range is concentrated on the production of the property. So that's a new experience, and I'm happy to do it.
Well, we're very happy you're here, and looking forward to the future. And I think you're right. I mean, I think, you know, that Chateau Tessier has always been very commercially aware. We're very happy that we have clients. And,
but I don't think you are representative of the production side. I mean, it's an exception rather than a generality.
Okay. Well, we always like being an exception. So I'm with Miriam, who's had a very happy lunch, and really, I'm going to ask, what do you think about you know, Asia as being spoken about very much as a sort of saviour for Bordeaux? And the question is, do you feel that that's the case? What do you think of the future for some of the vintages that we've got to sell now?
Well, don't speak to me about Asia unless we will speak until tomorrow. But, well, I'm very positive on this market, which is getting more and more matured. And I think that there's more and more potential in any kind of market in Asia. But globally, I think that although the recent months have been difficult, the response to our wines is remaining very positive. And I'm very proud and happy about it. I feel very happy to work here. And look at, for example, the 2007, when some people are starting to promote their 05 to get rid of their stocks. We are sold out in 07, so...
Always a good thing. Always a good thing.
Isn't it?
And we all also, we you know, obviously we never forget the clients that are, that have been that have provided the base of, which are European, obviously, and from South America, from the States, etc.
Yeah, our basic clients, with which have the chance to take over after Beatrice, and our clients in Belgium, in the UK, have really been very loyal to us, and I would like to say a very big thank you.
Yeah, sure. What's our general impression of 2010? Because I think that's what people want to know.
Well, yeah. It certainly looks like it's going to be nicely balanced. Alcohols are high, but acidities aren't too high. Certainly, pH is a worry to look for. Again, we'll have to see what happens at the end of fermentation, as you said, but certainly great colour. And certainly what we've been tasting up to now on the unfinished grind is very encouraging.
Okay, in the vines we've had a very dry vintage, as you probably know. That means that the crop has been quite little in quantity, but very interesting in terms of quality. And we haven't had any too high temperatures,
so spikes.
Aromas hasn't been burnt by the sunshine.
So we haven't got a 2003.
No, absolutely not. Sure. No.
What have we got? Have we got something between 2000 and 2005?
I would say between 2005 and 2009.
And 2009 is still going to top this.
Yes.
Neil is an optimist, so he's holding
out. No, I don't know. It's hard to see.